You can't carry the sun with you at night, but this insane flashlight can get you close. This is the Imalent MS12 Mini, and it's not exactly mini, but it is one of the brightest flashlights in the world, with almost 70,000 lumens of light crammed into a host barely larger than a soda can. This is so bright, it practically turns the night into day, illuminating a huge area, and it can even start fires with ease. This is absolutely incredible, amazing, awesome, and well, it's got some issues. So, should you actually consider buying it? With four 21700 lithium-ion batteries and 12 high-power Cree XHP70.2 LEDs, this light packs a serious punch and features three active cooling fans to keep itself safe from its own intense heat. Though not exactly small, it is significantly more powerful than even its hefty build might suggest. Imalent claims that this light will produce an incredible 65,000 lumens, and as it turns out, it easily meets and even exceeds that spec. It really is amazing at night. This is one of the most powerful flashlights you can get your hands on, and it's actually pretty easy to use as well. However, it's plagued by some poor design choices and has some glitches that could render it dangerous. While the output impresses, not much else does, and it all comes in at $400. First, let's talk about build. The MS12 Mini is technically mini compared to the massive older MS12 and MS18, and honestly, for something so powerful, it is pretty small and very portable. It's densely built of aluminum with a hefty 16-volt battery pack that has a barrel plug for the included charger, which fills the pack in about 2 hours. The head uses Cree XHP70.2s and a multi-well orange peel reflector made of plastic. The battery pack and head are completely sealed with Loctite, so modding is discouraged. Overall, the build is pretty good. The light feels very solid and seems reasonably durable. There are a couple rough edges though, such as the poor button quality and the weak indicator LED, which seems about right considering Imalent's poor reputation for quality control. The battery pack should have used USB-C charging instead of this barrel plug, and the inability to replace the cells is lame, but probably necessary when so much current is being pulled here, so I guess it's justifiable. That does mean though that you'll be stuck shelling out for Imalent's pricey battery packs. The good news is you can buy extras and quickly swap them out when they're depleted. There are also three cooling fans that blow air directly onto the light. These fans are in metal frames, which don't fully prevent your fingers from touching the blades, and there is no clear, easy way to replace them. The fans are definitely necessary due to the sheer output this thing provides. On the highest level, exact output is going to depend on the battery charge. The claim of 65,000 lumens seems ridiculous, but surprisingly, the MS12 Mini not only easily reaches that, but actually manages to exceed it by several thousand lumens. Regardless of charge level, I found it to usually hit 67,000 lumens on turbo, and when mostly full it will hit 70,000 plus. Even more impressive, after a fresh charge, the instant turbo is hit, I measured an astonishing 83,000 lumens, which firmly cements this as one of the very brightest flashlights you can possibly buy, if only for a split second. That amount of light might be impressive, but it can't be sustained. Output remains extremely high for the first minute, then plummets down to 13,000 lumens at 1 minute of runtime. This is still extremely bright, brighter than most flashlights that exist, and amazingly, this is held flat for the remaining 44 minutes of runtime, which altogether is very impressive. Even the lower modes are crazy bright, with level 5 producing 26,000 lumens and level 4 exceeding 11,000. These modes will of course drop in output due to heat buildup, but all still run stably at over 10,000 lumens for the whole rest of the run. This super high stable output is awesome to see. Runtimes are understandably short on the highest modes, but unfortunately the lower modes don't impress with their runtimes, and this really hampers the light's actual usability. The MS12 Mini is configured like a pretty standard hot rod style light, with a basic linear driver that provides direct drive on turbo using a FET. The battery pack uses 4 lithium-ion batteries in series, which together add up to about 16 volts, while these LEDs are designed to run at 12 volts. The driver gives the LEDs the voltage that they want, while absorbing the excess and burning it off as heat. The driver also features a FET, a component that basically connects the batteries directly to the LEDs for maximum power. This is what gives the light such incredibly high output on turbo without any complicated switching for the lower modes. This driver type is simple, compact, and inexpensive. However, there is one major downside: efficiency. This drive type is only about 70% efficient, which means low runtimes and massive amounts of heat. On turbo, the light immediately gets extremely hot, hot enough to easily start fires. Some of that heat is due to the LEDs, some is due to the light itself, while much of it is the result of the driver design. To help suppress the heat, the light is equipped with 3 high-speed cooling fans that blow air directly onto the driver pill. These fans are quite loud and always seem to impress people when they first spool up. However, while it's cool at first, it quickly just becomes annoying. And that's what you get to hear constantly, the whole time. It's, I don't know, kind of annoying, I think. And unfortunately, the cooling implementation just kind of sucks. The whole light will still get uncomfortably hot before long. The fan placement around the head means that your hand will pretty easily block either an intake or exhaust, and the thin frames make the fan blades easy to touch. They spin at high speed but are actually pretty weak, and even just shaking the light around will cause them to slow down and lose power. Worse than the fans, though, is the button used to operate the light. A flat metal cover lacking any prominent features makes it almost impossible to find in the dark, and it has a poor, indecisive action. This is literally the worst switch I've used on a flashlight to date. And as a bonus, because it's metal, the switch gets very hot along with the rest of the body, so using gloves to operate this light is almost a requirement, but that just makes the button harder to use. Thankfully, the interface is very simple. A press turns the light on and another turns it off. A double press activates turbo. While on, pressing and holding cycles the light upwards through the main modes. And that's it, plain, simple, and intuitive. The light memorizes the last used mode, and a quick triple press while on or off turns the light to the lowest mode, which is a critical feature to have, but is usually mapped to a press and hold from off, which I do think is superior, but at least it's here. Unfortunately, there is no real low mode here. The lowest level is a ridiculous 2000 lumens, which is higher than turbo on most lights. And it's so inefficient, this mode won't even run for a full 5 hours, which means that not only is the light always blindingly bright, it's literally incapable of running for an entire night's worth of usage. For a supposedly practical $400 flashlight with 4 21700s and 12 high-efficiency LEDs, that is simply unacceptable. Anyways, what pressing and holding the button from off does is activate the fans. Normally they run automatically at the higher levels, but when manually turned on this way, they'll just run until they're turned back off. It's great to have this option, but it would have worked way better if it was bound to a triple click. And you thought we were done talking about the fans. Nope, there's more problems here. The fans play the critical role of keeping the light cool. They always run at level 3 and above, and turn off with the light. This means that if you run the light on high and then turn it off, the fans will also shut off, and the light will remain super hot. Even worse, when doing my runtime tests, I found that they held the same RPM the entire time, right up until the last 4 minutes of the run. At that point, the fans actually shut off before the light itself did. With its, again, impressive stable output of over 10,000 lumens, the light simply sits and cooks for at least 3 whole minutes before shutting off. This is a very concerning and potentially dangerous oversight, and is something that needs to be fixed. Instead of just running at a constant speed, the fans need to react to the actual heat in the light, and output should start to drop if it gets too hot. Even worse, the lowest mode, strangely, tends to not work properly when on low battery, and will sometimes just fail to turn on. At one point, I plugged it into charge after being depleted, and when I returned an hour later, it had somehow turned itself on to the lowest mode. Because of the high-low mode and the lack of intelligent temperature control, the light got extremely hot and could have overheated or started a fire. This is a huge problem, and these glitches and lazy design render this light potentially very dangerous. This is pretty much just a straight floodlight, with a light cast around a wide area. By brute force, it does still manage to throw quite far, but distant objects won't really be visible anyways, as the light reflecting off nearby objects will be overwhelmingly bright. The rated intensity is 250,000 candela, though I and other reviewers only measure about half that, so it's certainly not a throw monster. These LEDs are a pleasant daylight white of about 5600K, which is really nice to see, though they are low CRI, so color rendition isn't particularly great. Overlapping multi-well reflectors generally result in ugly, clover-like beams with many artifacts, but here the large number and floody nature of the LEDs compensates for that, and results in pretty nice, reasonably clean beam. Overall, the light quality is nothing special, but it's perfectly fine, and the super floody nature is awesome at night, as it just illuminates everything in a huge area. So, yeah, okay. It's compact, it has a nice beam, is easy to use, and might be brighter than the future of America, but once you get past the initial wow factor and look at this light as a whole, it's just okay at best. Design flaws, user interface issues, poor mode spacing, overheating problems, and an inefficient driver all drag this light down and make its $400 price tag very difficult to justify. I think this design just needed more time in the oven before release, and I'm not sure I can recommend it unless you really know what's going on here. Yes, it is awesome and very fun to use, but it's simply too flawed to be considered for anyone needing a real practical flashlight. But if it appeals to you, go ahead. I don't think you're going to regret it. Well, this video ended up a lot more negative than I had hoped it would be. I honestly do love this light. It's actually really fun to use, but Imalent just didn't deliver a properly refined product. I genuinely hope that they can take these criticisms and use them to further improve their future lights. Because this is something special, even with its flaws, and I would love to see a better version of this. Imalent did send this light to me free of charge, which I really appreciate. I also appreciate their patience, as it took me a long time to complete this review, and they were very understanding of that. So Imalent, when you watch this, thank you. I was not otherwise paid for this review, so all test results and opinions are my own. I hope this video was helpful, I really do. I hope you maybe enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one.